to compromise the integrity of the text.
Yes.
I would not want to be esogenical.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah, right.
In my sanctified imagination.
Yeah, that's good.
All right.
That's good.
Is it possible?
Mother.
I mean, could it be that since 40% of pastors and 47% of pastors' wives suffer from burnout and are literally wounded warriors because of frantic schedules and unrealistic expectation, that this particular priest, look at your neighbor and say, just this priest, this one isolated case, just couldn't handle anything else for the day. Is it possible that when he saw the certain man who had been robbed and wounded and stripped of his clothes and left half dead, that he was too emotionally drained himself and overwhelmed, and just that day, just look at your neighbor and say, just that day.
Just that day. Work the text, mama.
He just wanted to get home to Jericho.
Come on now.
After all, he had eulogized one of his best members that morning.
Lord have mercy.
He wrestled with the board about the budget and trying to meet the budget.
Mother!
In the same day, he made a couple of hospital visits. He went to the local jail with a grief-stricken mother to see about her son. He checked his emails on his i5, and all of them needed answers like yesterday. He listened to his voice messages of 25 or more of his two phones, not his one cell phone, but his two cell phones.
Two phones.
And every one of those messages sounded deeply distressed.
Yes, Lord.
In trouble.
Yes, Lord.
Is it possible that the priest that day was just not having a good day?
Come on, mother. It's possible.
And then Jesus moves to traveler number two.
All right.
Who was the Levite. Levites came from the tribe of Levi. They were assistants to the priest in the temple. They offered hymns to enhance the worship and tended to other issues of liturgy. Jesus said the Levite came and looked on the certain man who had been robbed, wounded, stripped of his clothes, and left half dead. He went over, at least he did go over to look at the man.
Uh-huh.
He saw